Good evening. I'm Laura Lloyd, and I'd like to welcome you to this evening's presentation of The Blood Will Never Lose Its Power. Would you stand and sing with us?
Was the Word, and the Word was with God. The Word was God. The Word was with God in the beginning. Through Him, all things were made, and without Him, nothing was made that has been made. In Him was life, and that life was the light of men. The light shines in the darkness, but the darkness did not recognize it. The light shines through the darkness, but the darkness didn't even notice. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Even in his own land and among his own people, he wasn't wanted. But to those who believed him, to those who believed in his name, to those who believed he was how he claimed and would do what he said, he gave the right to become children of God. And we have seen his glory, the glory that a one and only son can only receive from his Father, full of grace and truth. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. The Word became human and lived here on earth among us. And having become human, he stayed human. He humbled himself. He didn't accept any special privileges. He lived a selfless, obedient life, to die a selfless, obedient death. And the worst kind of death at that, crucifixion. But it was our sins that did that to him. He was bruised and wounded for everything that we've done wrong. He was wounded for our transgressions, pierced for our iniquities. He did all this just so we could be whole. And God exalted him to the highest place, gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee would bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth. Every tongue confess that Jesus is the master of all. This is the resurrection, that the Son came and gave his life, that he extended an invitation to know the God of all creation, that he offered us love when we knew no peace, that he offered us relationship when all we knew how to do was keep and break a bunch of rules. This is the resurrection, that in his death we have come to know life, that we can freely offer our life to him.
Thank you. Done. every crime against humanity, every genocide, every unspeakable act of oppression and tyranny, every act of terrorism, every starving nation ignored, every drop of martyred blood, every orphan and widow abandoned, every stranger in need passed by, every deviant and perverse lifestyle, every marriage torn asunder, every word uttered in hate, every injustice, every theft, every grudge, every bitterness, every lust, every fear, every lie, every doubt, every one. Oh, the weight of the cross. Oh, the strength of the one who bears it.
Jesus loves me, this I heard. I even read it in God's word, and in my mind I truly did believe. But not until I faced the cross did I see what loving me had cost. It was then my heart was changed at Come now and walk with me.
know, the cross is a historic event that actually happened 2,000 years ago. And the resurrection happened, that Jesus rose again from on the third day to conquer death and to give you life. It's a historic event. We see it recorded in the scripture. But what is exciting is the cross, the resurrection, gives us power for our lives today. We live in troubled times, but we serve a God who has provided all for us. He's taken care of it. Christ's blood shed on the cross for us pays the price for our sin. We are forgiven from our sin when we trust Christ as our Savior. And we are given life because of his resurrection. And I know this is a special Easter for us, that we'll be able to have a worship celebration together this Easter. And it will be a very exciting time next week when we do that. I just wanted to share this verse with you. John 19:30 says this, "It is finished." That word in the original was what they used when someone had a bill that needed to be paid. When they paid their bill, they stamped it, and it said, "It is finished" on the top. So that's the idea. Jesus paid all of the price for your sin when he died on the cross. All of your sins are covered, and you're welcome to accept that gift that Jesus paid for on the cross. The Apostle Paul writes in 1 Corinthians 15, verses 3 through 6, concerning the resurrection of Jesus from the dead. "For I delivered to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the scripture, that he was buried and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the scripture. And that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12, and then he appeared to more than 500 brothers at one time." These are historic events, and you have to reckon with the truth of scripture in your own life. Christ is risen. He is risen indeed. And we see the results of this death on the cross and his resurrection. In verse 55 of 1 Corinthians 15, it says this, "O death, where is your sting? O death, where, or, O death," I'm sorry, let me say that again. "O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law." Now listen to this verse. "But thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ." Have you made this historic event of the crucifixion and the resurrection a personal decision in your own life? Have you allowed it to impact you? It is the most monumental event that has ever occurred, and we are still celebrating it today. Verse 58 of 1 Corinthians 15 concludes this way, and I leave this with you as an encouragement. "Therefore, my beloved brothers, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that in the Lord your labor is not in vain." Let's pray. Dear God, thank you so much for your love for us. Thank you that the blood never loses its power, that it is still effectual for today as it was 2,000 years ago. And anyone, no matter how sinful of a lifestyle someone has lived, they can turn it over to Christ and you erase. You give them a new beginning, forever forgiven, as we sang. What a wonderful truth that we can live free, burden free from our sin because of what Christ did on the cross and that he conquered death. Bless each one of us as we leave this place tonight, and may we have a wonderful Easter celebration. In Christ's name we pray, amen. Before we go, I just want to thank Laura Lloyd for directing the choir and Ellen Stuckey for directing the one song, writing the one song and playing, and Jackie Leach also playing the piano. So we want to thank them. And we're also thankful for our tech crew, Ryan and Garrett and Mary and all those on the video cameras. Thank you for your help up there, upstairs. And we especially want to thank the choir and your commitment to sing. It was a blessing to be with you and singing along. So yes. And Jerry, I thought I remembered everybody, but Jerry said, remember to thank those who came tonight. So thank you. Thank you for coming. So if nobody hears what we have to sing, that's not good. So thank you for coming tonight. God bless you. Take care.